So today I'm going to look at this thing. This is a Farmtek Polaris timer system. I've shown these various times in my videos. I've done various repairs and servicing work on the actual poles themselves, and I think I've done one or two of these as well, like a display replacement, I think, things like that. Anyway, I was asked to look at this one, and apparently it's got an issue with the display, so I'm going to show you that. Turn it on, nothing there. Turn it on again, nothing there. It's kind of there. See, there's something there. Sometimes it comes up properly, sometimes it doesn't. It never actually boots fully. It's just like this. Now, I already pulled this thing apart, because when I'm given this, I had time to have a quick look at it. So I've already pulled it apart and established probably why it's doing this. And here's another example. What it has been doing is booting up with a whole bunch of segments lit up like this. But that isn't actually booted. It should actually have like a boot up message and stuff up here. It should go to zeros and what have you. So yeah, it's like it's actually not booting up. It's starting, but whatever random garbage is in the RAM is what gets put on the screens. It's what it looks like anyway, so I don't think the microprocessor is actually running. And I'll show you why. The first thing you do is obviously check batteries, right? Well, I'm confident it's not the batteries. I got told I tried different batteries already. Here's a clue. Can you see this thing here? Does that look just ever so slightly dodgy to you? Oh yeah. So I was going to remove the bottom casing, which just lifts off. Normally there's little O-rings on here. I've already taken those out. I left those out before when I pulled it apart. Now, can you see what's wrong? Can you see what's wrong now? Can you see it? How about now? See it now? Yeah, that's not good. Well, it's corrosion over the board there. And I'll show you something else once I get it apart. I've got to get the board out, then I'll show you. So you can see where that corrosion is just there. The back of the board over here, opposite it, is the crystal oscillator. So there's the oscillator for the processor right there. So I'm thinking it's affecting this circuit and killing that oscillator. So the oscillator is probably not running. I'm guessing because of the corrosion on the back means it's not going to oscillate. And then that means the processor isn't running. So I'm hoping that all I've got to really do is clean off all this garbage here, repair the damaged traces, try and neutralize it as much as I can, and hopefully it will boot up then. Well, let's give it a brush for this. See, it's all coming off. Yeah, that's quite a mess there. Wow. Wow, that's actually built up quite a lot. Yeah, that's really interesting actually. I should have debuted lifting my desk. Yeah, there's actually quite a lot of corrosion build up there. That's quite serious. Right, brush ain't gonna do it. Need to scrape it. Yeah, let's give it a poke with a screwdriver. And there's a big chunk coming off. See that? If I get it in focus, maybe you can see it. Look at that. That's what came off. Yeah, this isn't good. I think I have to attack this with some white vinegar to help neutralize it a little bit. Hopefully it'll do something. But yeah, this is why you don't leave batteries and things, because otherwise it ends up eating away the circuit board. Yes. It's pretty bad. Alright, let's give it a spray. Bit of reaction going on, as you'd expect. Yeah, see that fizzing? It's reacting. So, yes. Maybe you can see the fizzing. Yep, stuff is happening. A bit more here. I was getting some fizzing from those pads just then. Just here, there are six pads, so I was getting some fizzing from that. But I think it's just about done now. There's not really much reaction going on now. So I think I should just give it a good wipe down and then stick some IPR on it to try and stop the reaction. And then, I don't know, maybe we should scrape these back a bit as well. See, there's traces being eaten away. I've got to stop all that as well. I've got to scrape that back, get it all fresh, probably tin it or something. I would make sure that these are all good up here as well. There's a lot wrong with this thing. It's all fixable. But yes, could have done without it. So I'm just going to use a fiberglass pin here. A little fiberglass brush. And let's give this a bit of a scrub with that. And try and get this corrosion removed with this as well. A bit more abrasive. There are some really fine tracks up here. So I've got to be careful that I don't wipe them out. Because I need to be able to rebuild them. Once I can see what they actually are. But I've got to get this solder mask back as well. Because otherwise it's going to eat it up. Underneath the solder mask. Because obviously it's eaten the solder mask away here already. But I need to get it right back. So there's nothing sitting underneath the mask still continuing further corrosion. But this is a good job for these fiberglass pins. Because they're abrasive enough to work. But not so much it completely wipes the tracks out straight away. Because if you just scrape it with a knife or something, it could easily cause further damage. So this is a bit more gentle. Get all this cleaned up and, say, tin stuff and get it all nice. It's going to take a while. So I've got it mostly cleaned off now. It's not too bad. Yeah, try and get in focus. It's not too bad there now. It's mostly cleaned off. Now I've also lifted the sticker a little bit to have a look underneath the sticker in case it's travelled up underneath there. It could have done. And you've got that trace that runs up the side here. It looks like it's needing a bit of a touch up there. I'm not sure if it's broken or not, I might measure that in a second. There's also this trace that runs up here. Can't really see it, but this goes up there. Pops up the other side. I need to check that one there as well, make sure that's looking intact. I mean, it doesn't look too bad, but I need to check it. There's a slight bit of corrosion just showing up there. The solder mask is gone, but I think I might need to touch it up. I might have to take this terminal off so I can get to them. Not a big deal. The solder's on. Right, let's desolder this terminal here, take it out. From this side, hopefully we can get some fresh solder to take, because the corrosion has actually travelled through the solder, it's actually killed the solder, so replacing the whole lot was a good idea, I think. It's not really wetting too well, it's only barely starting to take, there we go, it's starting to take now. Alright, so we can push it out, doesn't want to fall out though, but it is coming, so I just need to stick a screwdriver under there to apply a little bit of pressure so that I can get it to pop out. There you go, it's out. So at least we can, at the very least, we can clean this up properly and replace that solder, because that solder's just gone anyway. So I've been cleaning this up and some of these traces are actually gone. This one here is actually okay, that long one. This one here is actually gone in the middle, it's completely eaten away. You've got this track that came across here, it's split off like a Y shape. That's also completely gone. You can just maybe see if I get the light on it right. Might be able to see where the tracks used to be. These also on the way out, not great. Now I'm not sure what's going on with that top pad there, whether there's something supposed to be there or not. I'm not sure. Can't tell. Maybe it used to go to that big ground pad or the battery terminal pad, I'm not sure. But anyway, this wire here goes up there, it's definitely gone and it's replacing. This obviously needs sorting out, and that one there. So there's a few repairs to do there. Alright, so I've rebuilt all these traces. So this one here basically is centigrade. When I was scraping it back and just trying to rub it off and get the corrosion off, it basically disappeared, so it just started lifting off, so I had to basically remove that piece. So you've got a nice big solid bar there going up to that trace there, up to that pad. This one here coming across there, that one going up there. That one's okay, I just put some tinning over it, that was alright. These ones here which disappeared, so I run a piece to that. These ones here which are damaged at that one. That pad there doesn't appear to have anything going to it on either side of the board, so I think that one's okay. Unless I've missed something. These six pads here, these are this pin header. It's this pin header over here, anyway, which isn't actually being used, I think, maybe, unless it's programming, maybe. I've got to trim this little excess piece off here. I've put a piece of wire through that hole to mount one of those jumpers to. And it's got C7 here, it's got a little bit of corrosion looking there going on there, too. I might just give that a touch up, a bit of flux on it, clean it up. It's probably fine. Yeah, I will put the solder mask on there, that UV solder mask. I put some of that on here, cover it all up. Then I put the battery terminal back in again. There we can test it, and hopefully it will work. Yeah, we'll see. So I'm just doing the UV solder mask now, putting that down. So I've already done a layer, just the initial one, which I've hardened obviously, and then I've fitted the battery holder, and I'm doing some more to make sure it's definitely something between the battery holder and the wires, because these things do kind of like be liquid and run off the tops of things, so I don't want to risk the battery holder actually touching the bridge wires across here. So I just wanted to do a second layer, so it's definitely something bridging that gap so the battery holder cannot touch the wires, just to be absolutely sure. Obviously I still haven't tested this yet, but I'm just about at the point where I can. So I'm just doing this final bit of curing of this, and then I'm going to stick the sticker back down, and hopefully we'll be good. Fingers crossed it actually works. Now part of the problem I think was that the crystal legs are over here, and they were actually slightly corroded right across by a trace that goes up. So it could be bridging to the trace with the corrosion, or it could have been all this other stuff over here causing the problem. So yeah, anyway, should be good hopefully. I hope so. So you can probably just see you've got this trace comes up here, and there's a pad there, and there's a pad there. Those are the crystal, those two pads. So it's entirely possible that could have been what was killing it. But the whole lot needed fixing anyway, so it's fine. Well, let's test this out. We've got to put the antenna on it. Make sure that's off. Put some batteries in. We shall find out together if I have solved it or not. There we go. It booted up. Let's try it again. Initially we had some garbage on the screen, but it looks like it's probably okay. So it's interesting why it's got a garbage on the screen initially, but it is at least booting up now, so it is running properly. Okay, I need to actually test this out, see if it actually works. Alright, so I've got a pair of light curtains here. Just two poles is enough to actually test it. This is the emitter. This has got a whole bunch of infrared emitters in it. And this one here is a red pole, which is the receiver, which also sends signal to this. Let's turn this on. The back pole is already on. So they've got a signal. So if I put my hand through this bean now, this timer should start. Okay, let's get this propped up so you can see it. So this should start when I put my hand through. It does. Brilliant. It's not dead. Okay. And equally, I'll do it again. There we go. And if I start it manually, and if I put my hand through here, it should stop it. It does. So that's at least working. That's looking promising. It looks like it's functional again. And if we're worried about this boot up thing, it may or may not be an issue. I don't remember if it does it anomaly or not, but it definitely has that initializing thing, and it does seem to boot up fine. So let's actually look for the battery. Check battery. 89%, so that's absolutely fine. Battery level is not a problem in this case. So that's fine. Yeah, that's all. Still memories in there, looks like it's still good. Yep, it hasn't forgotten anything, so it all looks like it's all looking promising. I should probably check some other stuff. Standard output, yes. 4800, yep, it's still all good still. So no problems there. That's all working fine. Excellent. I can give this one back to them. That's quite a bit of work. It took me quite a lot of time to do all that work, you know, trying to scrape it all back and you know, use the fiberglass brush as much as possible. That can only do so much. I did end up getting the scalpel out eventually and actually scraping some traces back where the solder mask was quite thick on those ones, and the fiberglass pencil wasn't redoing it. But it worked. I mean, it's done the job, it's fixed, so I'm happy about that. I use yellow solder mask so I can see what I've worked on in the past. Obviously I could have used green to make it blend in more. I do have green, but I like to use the yellow one because now I can actually see work that I've done without being disturbed, hopefully. Check out the other videos down below. I've got other Farmtek repair stuff, so I've got videos about that and some other projects I've done with the Farmtek stuff, my timer system and my interface and my scoring system I use. I've done lots of videos on Farmtek stuff, so check those out. And subscribe over there if you're not already subscribed. Patreon support link over there to help support the channel and donate to it and stuff like that, and help me to buy things like bits of test gear to fix that kind of stuff, or stuff in my bag, whatever. Catch you later.